everyone, and welcome to my studio on my channel. I'm Angie, a mixed media textile artist. In my art practice, I love working with color, I love the process of creating art, but most of all, I love sharing those ideas with you here on this channel. When I first started as a textile artist, one of the things I noticed was that some of the processes that I like to do, such as screen printing, dyeing fabric, and rusting on fabric, used a lot of natural resources, such as water, disposable paper products, and disposable plastic products, and that really disturbed me. Over the years, I've tried to come up with ways to reduce, reuse, and recycle those resources so that I don't feel that I'm using them excessively. In today's video, I want to share some of those ideas with you. So let me get things set up, and I'll do just that. So I want to start out with the principle of reducing. And one of the things that I've done is tried to reduce my use of disposable paper products, such as paper towels, napkins, even baby wipes. Because if I do use a baby wipe, I will recycle it instead of dispose of it. So this roll of paper towel started out as a normal size roll, and it's been in my bathroom for almost a year now. So I do keep paper towels in my bathroom because I do have classes and I have friends that come over, and of course they'll want to be able to use paper towels to dry their hands. But for me, I use a hand towel, and that really has cut down the consumption on paper towels for me, because, you know, especially now with this time of coronavirus, you are constantly washing your hands way more than we did before. And if I used a paper towel, every time I did that, I'd go through a roll of paper towel in probably 2 days. Now, I use hand towels, but I have a number of hand towels, so I can switch them out every day if I need to. And in place of paper towels in my studio, I now use these washcloths. I buy this entire 18-pack of washcloths from Walmart for under $5. And I use them for everything. When I'm dyeing fabric, if I do a spill or any type of spill, I grab one of these for cleanup instead of going to a paper towel. When I need to clean tools of paint, I have these. I have an entire laundry basket of these, so I can go through a lot of them and wait until I have a washer load full, and then I wash them and recycle and reuse them. I also like to use these flour sack towels, also from Walmart. This is a pack of 5 for, I think it's $5. Between these two, I hardly ever use paper products in cleanup, any spills, or cleaning my hands, or cleaning my tools. So this has greatly reduced my use of paper towels. That's why I can have a roll like this, a full-size roll, last me almost a year. I've also had this roll of paper towels back here in my dye area for over a year. So by using towels and cloth washcloths, I really can cut down on the use of throwaway paper products. Another way I like to conserve in the studio is conserving water. Dyeing fabrics and screen printing, it uses a lot of water, especially on the dyed fabrics when you go to rinse the fabric out. And for the rinsing, the first rinse should consist of cold water, preferably ice cold or very cold water. And here in Florida, you never get cold water out of the tap. So what I used to do is I had probably about 10 ice cube trays, and I would fill up the ice cube trays, dump them into the water to make the water cold, and then I would rinse my fabric, and all those ice cubes would get poured down the sink, and I'd have to fill up the trays and do it all over again. And to me, that was quite a bit of water that I wasted. Water bills here are quite expensive, so I was looking for ways to conserve my water usage. And one day it dawned on me that I didn't have to do those ice cube trays. I could have a perpetual ice cube. Now you can go and buy those ice packs, but I don't want to spend any more money than I have to. I'd rather spend that money on fabric. So it dawned on me, if I froze water in recycled water bottles, I could put those ice cubes into my bucket of water, let the water get cold, and then I could take them out and refreeze them. So that way I wasn't just basically throwing water down the drain and having to do it all over again. So now I have a perpetual ice cube. So I get to recycle my water bottles, and I get to recycle the water in them. It eventually gets to the point where the water doesn't have very much color to it. So that means that almost all of the dye has been rinsed out of the fabric, So I can take this water now and use it to water my ornamental plants. Now, I don't water anything that's edible, nothing from my garden, but this is a perfect way for me to water my potted plants and recycle or reuse this water. Another way I try to reduce my environmental footprint in my art practice is by reusing things. I have here several different types of containers. These are mostly yogurt containers. So if you can't tell, I eat a lot of yogurt. And these are perfect containers for dyeing fabric in. I couldn't buy anything better. And so rather than send these to the landfill or even, our city does do recycling, but still, it's better if I can use these and not go out and buy something else. I also will use food storage bags for dyeing fabric in. And I use these things until they fall apart. So I will rinse them out, hang them out on a line, and reuse them over and over and over again. And sometimes they get a little hole in them. In that case, I just patch them with a bit of Gorilla Tape, and I just keep on using them. You know, I know these are plastic, and while it's easy to say I don't want to use plastic in my studio, sometimes it's not very practical. Yeah, I could use mason jars for dyeing fabric in, but I'm one of the biggest klutzes in the world, and if I started using glass in my studio, it wouldn't be a pretty thing. So I do like to use these plastic containers because for me they're safer and I don't have to worry about breaking something, but I like to use them over and over and over again until I probably won't be able to destroy these things. A third way that I try to reduce my environmental impact in my studio is to recycle as much as I can. This is some paper packaging material that came with some orders, and this is recycled coffee filters. So I like to recycle this stuff. Of course, yes, I can put it in the recycling bin, and our city does have a good recycling system, but what if I could use it instead of just dumping it into the recycle bin? So I do use this in some of my artwork, and I'll show you the in-between state. This is a coffee filter, one of the large ones. Now I did buy these coffee filters. In full disclosure, I bought the large ones, but the smaller ones are recycled from my coffee. I drink a lot of coffee, and I don't use one of those single serve coffee makers because I'd spend my entire day making a cup of coffee. So I use a regular coffee pot, and I like to use the paper filters instead of one of those permanent filters. It killed me though to have to throw these away. So instead of throwing them away, I started keeping them, but it was a long time before I figured out what to do with them. And what I've done with them is I've laid them on rusty metal and the rust transfers to the filter, okay? So I do a lot of rust dyeing in my artwork, but these coffee filters, they rust beautifully. Absolutely beautifully. So that's what they start out with after I rinse all the coffee grounds out of them. So that's what they look like, and that's what they become. In addition to the packaging material, I also like to just recycle any type of paper products. So here I have a newspaper. This is a newspaper that's in a different language than I speak, and I find the language to be very beautiful, their characters to be very, very beautiful. So I like picking up what's foreign language, what's foreign to me, and using it in my artwork because I think the letters, the characters are so graphic, and I love that. So this is a piece that I laid on a rusty piece of metal, and the rust from the metal would just transfer to the paper and create these beautiful, beautiful organic patterns that I don't know how you can get any other way. And this is some of the brown wrapping paper that or packaging paper that I recycle and lay on the rusty metal. I mean, just look at that. Isn't that absolutely gorgeous? So I like to do that with these papers, and I use them in my artwork. And to me, it's different from anything that I could buy. It's totally different from things I can buy. So I'm preventing all of this paper from going to the landfill, and I get to create some beautiful works of art with it. So another thing that I like to recycle is I like to go to thrift stores and purchase framed art stretched on canvas. And I'm not interested in the art per se. What I'm looking for is a well-made frame that's in good shape. You see, this frame is nicely made and it has this extra bar down the middle. I like to take these and strip off the old artwork and then stretch my work onto it. That way I have a nice frame for my artwork and it didn't cost me very much money. I usually only pay a dollar or two for these stretch art and I've gotten them in all sizes. So that's another way that I recycle here in my studio. So all of the art that I have on my gallery wall that you see here, that's art has been, I've used those recycled frames that I purchased from the thrift store. So, and this is just a small portion. I have many more that I don't have up yet. So you can see I've saved myself a lot of money and I've prevented a lot of things from going to the landfill. So look around. I'm sure there's some way that you can maybe take this and use it in your studio practice. Well, guys, those are just a few of the ways that I try to reduce my environmental impact in my studio as an artist. I know they may seem like small things, and they are small things, but I'm a believer of a lot of small things can add up to big things. So if I do my small thing, and someone else does their small thing, and someone else does theirs, all of these small things can add up to major impacts. I know that there's no way that I can do one thing that would be a major impact on the environment, but I can do a lot of little things. So, okay, I'll get off my soapbox now, but I hope you've enjoyed this video and I hope you found something that you may be able to implement into your studio practice and do your part to reduce the environmental impact that you have. And if you have, let me know that down in the comments. I'd love to know if there's something that I do that you may be able to use. And if you have other things that you do in your studio, let us know about those too. If we all share with each other, we can all do our part, our little part, to make a big impact. Well, that's it for today. I hope to see you back here again soon. But until then, have a beautiful day. Bye now.